Asian markets were mixed on Tuesday as data showed the COVID-19 Delta variant sapping economic activity in China, where the services sector contracted for the first time since March last year, overshadowing record performance on Wall Street. Philippine shares, fresh from the National Heroes Holiday, were down at the start, but eventually finished higher. First Metro Securities' Robbie Samson is cautiously optimistic, citing the surprisingly good performance of the index in August and the expected pickup in volumes every September.
That the effect of lockdown now and moving forward won't be as bad as last year, and I think that's what the market is taking into account during this rally. It makes sense to lower the GDP forecast given, as we said earlier, the relatively higher cases in the region. But for us, we are looking months ahead, especially that the stock market is a forward-looking mechanism once the cases actually ease. So we are looking at healthy household balance sheets, labor market recovery, and resilient remittances.
Meanwhile, over the long weekend, Moody's Analytics and Fitch Solutions cautioned against risks brought by the Delta variant. Moody's Analytics says the Philippines and Indonesia will likely struggle the most with less effective COVID-19 policies due to vaccine shortages, creating uncertainty on the timing of a rebound. Meanwhile, Fitch Solutions revised downward its growth forecast for emerging Asia to 7.8% from 7.9%, citing constrained vaccination rates and the emergence of the more transmissible Delta variant. In corporate stories, AC Energy is launching a green bond and listing it on the Singapore Exchange with details on the size and terms to be disclosed at a later date. This is part of the company's $1.5 billion medium-term note program approved by SGX this month. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.